Good morning, students. Myself, Alka Shukla. Today, I am going to start your new chapter. Chapter first, Matters in Our Surrounding. Now the question arises, what is matter? Matter is a thing which is present in our environment. The air we breathe, the food we eat, stone, cloud, sky, table, chair, pen, pencil, books, etc. Each thing is a matter. And the definition of matter is that anything that occupies space and having mass is called matter. Example, the air we breathe, the food we eat, stones, clouds, etc. Each thing is a matter. The air we breathe, the food we eat, stones, clouds, etc. Each thing is a matter. So, any substance that occupies space and having mass is called matter. Now, we will discuss next topic, classification of matter. So, classification of matter. Early Indian philosopher classified matter into five basic elements. This is called Panchtattva. These five basic elements are air, water, sky, earth, fire. Okay. Then, according to them, every living and non-living things are made up of these five basic elements. Matter can be classified according to early Indian philosopher is as early Indian philosophers classify matter into five basic elements called Panchtattva. Five basic elements are air, water, earth, sky, and fire. So, first classification is that, and according to them, they said all living and non-living things. All living and non-living things are made up of these five basic elements. So this is the classification according to Indian philosophers. Nowadays, matter can be classified on the basis of physical and chemical nature. So we will discuss matter according to physical and chemical nature. Matter classification of matter on the basis of physical nature. On the basis of physical nature, it may be classified as solid, liquid, and gas. And next one is that classification of matter on the basis of chemical nature. Chemical nature, it can be classified as elements, compounds, and mixtures. So these are the classifications of matters which we are using in a nowadays. The next topic is physical nature of matter. What is the physical nature of matter? We will discuss. Physical nature of matter. First one, matter is made up of certain particles which differ in size, shape, and nature from other type of matter. And the second physical nature of matter is that the particles of matter are very small. Made up of certain particles which differ in size, shape, and nature from other types of matter. And the second one is the particles of matter are very small. But matters के जो particles होते हैं बहुत ही छोटे होते हैं. Particles of matter are very small. This is the physical nature of matter. Now we will discuss activity 1.1. The activity 1.1 is that first of all we take 100 ml beaker and fill the beaker with water and mark the label of water. Take 100 ml beaker and fill it with water and also mark the label of water. Next, dissolve some salt or sugar with the help of glass rod. Then after adding sugar or salt in water, what do we observe? Is there any change in water level? Or what has happened to the salt? Is it appear or it disappear? Does the level of water change? Water level is also changes. Water means level of water आपका change हुआ, increase हुआ और decrease हुआ. What happens to after adding sugar or salt in water? So the observation is that if we add salt or sugar in water, then salt or sugar dissolve in water. We observe that salt or sugar dissolve in water. And second question is that what do you think has happened to the salt? Where does it disappear? Where does the salt goes? Salt particles filled in the gaps between the particles of water. They take place in gaps. Particles of salt is filled between the gaps of water particles. And the next question, does the level of water changes? Water का level आपका कम होगा या ज़्यादा होगा? अगर वही salt आपका gaps के अंदर filled हो जाए, water particles के अंदर जो gaps थे, उसमें आपका salt particles filled हो जाए, तो water का level बढ़ेगा या घटेगा? So there is no change in the level of water. Because salt is filled between the gaps of water particle. That's why there is no change in the water level. Doing this experiment, we get this. Now, your homework is read chapter first and prepare a notes on certain topics . This is your homework. Okay, thank you, class.